Hello everyone, and in this short video tutorial we shall be talking about how to install and run both Python 2 and Python 3 on a Windows machine. I'm Vivek Mishra. The first step in our process is to understand if you have Python already installed on your machine. Our target objective is to try and get both Python 2 and Python 3 running in parallel in a system so that we can work with both the scenarios. In this case, first we will check if some Python version is already installed on our machine, and we will find that there could be four different scenarios. One, probably the best case scenario, both Python 3 and 4 are installed on your machine and we are ready to go. And an extreme opposite scenario would be that Python is not installed, neither version 2 nor version 3. And that would be an excellent use case for starting to learn from scratch how to set up your system to use Python. In fact, in this session, we will be starting from this particular step. Another scenario, which is a popular scenario, that only Python 2 is installed, Python 2 being a very, very popular scripting language and a lot of project depends on it. It is highly likely that if you have only one Python version installed, it may be Python 2. And probably a futuristic scenario is you have only Python 3 installed. But going forward, probably this would be the scenario for all of us as Python 2 reaches its end of life on January 1st, 2020. So how do I check what Python version is installed? This is a simple step. You can start your command prompt and you can search for a command where Python. So if we run a command such as where Python, in the best case scenario, I would see something like Python 3.7 is installed here and Python 2.7 is installed here. You should also run where py to see if py is available, and we will talk more about py later in the series. And as I said, an extremely opposite scenario, the one from which we will be beginning, would be when you run where Python, you see that the where command fails to find the Python installed. Let me remind you, this installation, this video is all about how to do it on a Windows machine. We shall be trying to have a different video for MacBook and Linux systems. But apart from these two scenarios, there are other use cases such as only Python 2 is available or only Python 3 is available. And we would be looking into those two scenarios also as we proceed along. If only Python 2 is installed, then we would need to install Python 3. If only Python 3 is installed, you may not need Python 2 unless you have to migrate some of your old code and probably you want to run your legacy code, maintain it for quite some time. But let me remind you, as Python 2 is reaching its end of life in January 2020, probably installing Python 2 will be optional. In this demonstration, we'll start how to set up Python from scratch, assuming that we have no Python installed in our system. We'll start, we will download Python, we will install Python 2 and make our system ready for Python 2. And by installing Python 2, we would enter the scenario one where only one of the Python version is available. And then we'll go on to install Python 3 on the top of Python 2. And finally, we'll set up an environment to make sure that we can use both the Pythons in our system. So let's get started. The first thing I would do is to start a command window to check what version of Python is installed on our machine. And on this command prompt, we shall be trying out where Python. So where is a very useful Windows utility, which can check and let you know the path of an executable. If an executable is present on more than one path, it lists all the paths. We have no version of Python installed on our machine. So let's head to the Python's website and download Python 2 and install it. In case you do not need Python 2, you can skip the discussion on installing Python 2 and you can meet us in the next section where we will start to install Python 3. So now I would open my browser and head to python.org website. On python.org website, as you can see, there is a download for the latest version of Python, which on the date of recording is Python 3.7.4. But we head to the download section and search for all releases, because we are not looking forward for installing Python 3, rather we are installing Python 2. In the all release section, we would head to install Python 2.7.16, which was released on March 4, 2019. And going further down, we realize that we'll need some versions. So you see we have Windows versions for Mac and the source world release. We would be installing this version of Python on our system, which is Windows x86-64 MSI installer. This installer can work even without administrative privilege in Windows. Now that the Python version 2 is downloaded, we would run the MSI file to install the Python. You can choose whether you want to install for all users or just for you. It depends on your administrative privilege. If you have admin privilege, you may like to install it for all user, if there are multiple user, or you may just install for yourself. I would be going with the first option as I have the admin privilege on my system. It offers to install Python on the C drive, root, Python 27, and I would highly recommend to keep this directory as it is. It asks for the options that we need to install, and one of the options which I would actually recommend you is to add Python to your path. That would be helpful at a later stage and will let Python installation complete. I being an administrator, it asks me for the user permission, and now Python is getting installed on my machine. That should take a couple of seconds and it will resume once the installation is finished. Now that Python has been installed, I should be in a position to run Python from the command window. But let us understand, any path changes, they are not known to an existing instance of the running process such as a shell. And if I try to search for where Python again, it would still fail because the updates on the path is not known to the command prompt which were opened before the paths were updated. So in order to test it, we should start with a new command window. Any environmental change would require that. Not only it applies to command window, but any applications such as IDEs which are running. Because typically applications look into environment variable when they start. Now when I run where Python, you realize that system recognizes that we have a version of Python installed here. And now when I say Python version, it says we have version 2.7.6 of Python installed on my machine. Now that Python 2 is installed, we would focus on installing Python 3. To install Python 3, we would head away to python.org website. And as you can see, we have a latest Python 3.7.4 download available here. we can use this link to go and search for the Python installation version that we are looking forward, and we would be using Python executable installer, which is this version, for a 64-bit system. Now that Python 3.7 is downloaded, let's click the MSI installer to install Python 3. And here I would recommend you to once again add Python 3.7 to the path. Also notice that it is giving a default choice to install launcher for all users, which is Python community recommendation, and I would also endorse this recommendation. But one point I would like to differ is I don't like to install Python in such a long path. So I would customize my installation and move to the next step, where we get the option to change the path on which Python should be installed. And once again, I would strongly recommend to install it on the root Python 37, and we'll install it for all users. The UI is different for Python 2 and Python 3. And you will click install. Now notice, if you're installing only for yourself, you do not need an admin privilege, but the moment you choose for all user, you need admin privilege. So depending on whether or not you have admin privileges, you should choose this option. And now Python 3 is getting installed on my system. Once Python 3 is installed, we would resume this video. Now that our Python 3 is successfully installed, we should be testing our setup currently. And as I already told, the old command windows are now stale. To test it, we'll start a new command window and we'll run where Python. And now we see that Python 3.7 and 2.7 is installed. So now our system has got both versions of Python, that is version 3 and version 2. But which version of Python will actually run? If you run the version command or run the Python with the version switch, it should give you the version of Python that is used by default. And it says Python version 3. So now, while we have both versions of Python, Windows would use the version of Python which comes first in the path, which in our case is Python 3.7. So the question is how to run Python 2 conveniently. And here enters what we call as a Python launcher. Let us now configure how to run both Python 2 and Python 3 on your system. In the previous section, we have installed both Python 3 and Python 2. They are installed on our system. But now we need a convenient way to access them when we need. To solve this problem, Python 3 comes with a special Python launcher known as Py. Let us try to locate Py first, and we would find that Py is installed in the Windows directory. Now, if I just try to find the Py version, you realize that Py version is also referring to Python 3. And Python is already referring to Python 3. So the question is, how do I run Python 2? And we have a very simple, convenient answer. If I try py minus 2, we are suggesting Python launcher to use the version 2 of installed Python on our system. And if I do this version, I'm actually connecting to Python 2. In fact, we can also try it on the shell. py2 gives me python 2 cell. And py3 gives me the python 3 cell. So conveniently, I can use py2 and py3 instead of using python. But there is another interesting option available for us. PyLauncher also uses a special environment variable known as PyPython. And if I set PyPython to 2, Py defaults to Python 2. And we could still run Py minus 3 worker. To sum up, if we have environment variable PyPython, Python launcher, that is Py, uses the provided version as the default version for Py. Another version can be opted by explicitly providing the switch. So here is our strategy. We can set PyPython to 2. And now we can run py command whenever we want to run Python 2. This PyPython version is only for Python launcher and not for the original Python command, which will still be driven by the path environment variable. And now when I run Python version, it is version 3. In our session, we would be using Py to mean Python 2 and Python to mean Python 3. As a last step, we should be setting up this PyPython as an environment variable at the system level so that we don't have to set it every time we launch a new command window. To do that, we would search for environment variable here and we can edit the environment variable. Now you can edit the environment variable either at the system level or for your own account. By the way, both these options will take you to the same screen. So at this stage, it doesn't matter which one you choose. You get to this screen where we choose the environment variable options. And here I can configure it for an individual user or I can configure it for all the users. And here I can choose to create a new variable called PyPython and set it to the version 2. Now that PyPython has been set, I can close these windows. Now that we have set the environment variable, we will launch a new command window to test. And at this stage, if I say py version, it refers to the Python 2. And the Python version refers to Python 3. So now we can run both Python 2 and Python 3 parallelly on the system and run the runtime based on our preference and needs. That's all for this video. In the next section, we shall be discussing how to install and configure Visual Studio Code as a preferred IDE for writing applications in Python. So stay tuned and thanks for listening.